You want to implement an in-app camera in your Jetpack Compose Android app, which allows you to take a photo and store it in your app gallery. In this video, you will learn how. Hi guys, my name is Janek Reis. I hope you're doing well and I welcome you to a new video. Well, in one of my latest videos, I showed you how you can implement an in-app camera preview in Jetpack Compose with the help of CameraX. One part in this video was missing. Therefore, in this video, we will build up on the code base and you will learn how to extend the camera in-app preview with the functionality to capture a photo and store it correctly so it gets visible in your device photo gallery. So now we're back in the GitHub repository I used for my last video about Jetpack Compose and CameraX. And now I will show you how I extended the repository so we can actually take a photo and store it in the app gallery. So if you haven't watched the video yet, make sure to check it out. And from this point on, you should feel a little bit familiar with this code. Here we still have our camera screen, and in the camera screen, there's still the camera content. And if we scroll down, we come back to the in-app camera preview, which we implemented using an Android view. And now there's an additional composable here, that is the last photo preview. So this preview takes the last picture we actually captured, and this captured photo is a regular bitmap, which you may already know. So, but how do we actually capture a photo now using the CameraX library? In the last video, I already teased it a little bit. Now we can just jump into the actual code for that. So we have here our extended floating action button, and this action button has an onClick function, which on the other hand calls the capture photo. So we have three input parameters here. One is the context. The second is the camera controller, which is actually coming from the CameraX library. And then we also have a callback, which passes a bitmap, which is, of course, the captured photo at the end. So let's take a look at the captured photo function here. Inside the captured photo function, you can see that we're still using here a main executor, and we also are still using the same build up for capturing a photo. But what we now do is that we access the image proxy and convert it to a bitmap. And afterward, we need to rotate the bitmap. And we can do that because we have the image info here from the image proxy, which on the other hand contains the rotation degrees. And this rotate bitmap here is just a little helper function. So let's quickly step through that. We use here a matrix that uses a pulse rotate function. And this function here counterclockwise rotates the bitmap at the end. And then we also use a pulse scale, which flips the bitmap horizontally and also vertically. Then afterward, we create with this information a new bitmap from the original bitmap and have the bitmap corrected from our capturing process. Afterward, we just pass the corrected bitmap to our onPhoto capture callback here. And then as the last step, we will clear up the resources. So we just call image.close. And now with this callback function here, we can quickly scroll up. We see, it gets passed to the camera content here. And then finally, here in the camera screen, it gets passed to the view model. And here we have the store photo in gallery function. So let's go in here. And as you can see, we have here a use case that is called save photo to gallery use case. So what we finally want to achieve is that the photo gets visible in the regular gallery app of your choice. And that is handled by this use case. So we have this function here that says view model scope launch. So we launch a new coroutine, and then we call this use case here with the captured bitmap. So let's jump into that. So here you can see that we switch here to the IO dispatcher because we are using here input and output operations. So we write to our media store at the end, and then we use a content resolver because we want to write to the media store. And whether you are above or equal to API version 29, which is the same version code as Q. Then you use here the volume external primary. And if you're below that, you use the external content URI. Then we have here content values. And these content values actually describe the image you want to save in the media store. So you have various options you can use, like some examples here, date taken, date modified, author, and so on. So you don't have to use all of those. Of course, the path here is relevant, and also the actual state of the media store. So you should use, if you're once again above or equal to Android version Q, is pending. So you say, I'm currently editing this file. And if you are done later in the process, you will say image content values put media column is pending to zero. But let's quickly come back to the next line here, because here we say, insert the image content values we defined here and use the image collection we defined here above in the earlier process. And with this reference via this URI here, we can actually write to that media store using the resolver once again. So we can just say open output stream, use the URI as a reference, and then we can use a little helper function that is called use. So it will automatically clean up the resources after the usage of this output stream here. And then we just need to say capture photo bitmap compress. And because it's a photo, we use here JPEG. You could also use, for example, PNG. We want to have the full quality and want to write to the output stream. And just to mention, if you have never used it before, this check not null is just a little helper. So you don't have to say, if output stream is not null, then do this or that. You can just use here this check not null and put in the output stream. So the compiler knows, okay, after this line, this output stream will definitely be not null. Because if it's null, an exception will be thrown here. But that's not a problem, because we wrap this whole block here inside a run catching block and evaluate this result at the end. So the next line is then the mentioned cleanup. So we say here, for the version greater than or equal to Android version code Q once again, set this is pending to zero and update the URI here once again with this value. And then at the end, we return a Kotlin result. So if you want to handle some error cases, which might occur, then you could do that by evaluating the Kotlin result here. But now enough of the talk. Here is the actual running app. And now I can just click here, take photo. So thumbs up. And as you can see, down here is the mentioned preview. But let's see if this photo actually got saved in the gallery. So let's quickly jump here to Google Photos, in this case on the emulator. And as you can see, here is the great photo of me. And by that, we achieved our final goal. We have a fully functional camera app with an in-app preview, a function to capture photo, and all of that in Jetpack Compose. Of course, the last part can also be used in a regular Android XML app, but in this case, we focus on Jetpack Compose. But as you saw, it's not that complicated to implement a camera functionality in your Android app. Did you already have some use cases where you implemented an in-app preview and also some camera functionality? Let me know in the comments. And as always, I hope you had some takeaways. Like the video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, activate the notification bell, and I hope to see you soon.